has its own very distinguishable work ethic. I think people here, you know, they put their heads down, they get the job done, and they don't complain. Almost like a very blue-collar ethic to it. And I think that that's carried on into how August Burns Red operates. You know, we never had like a lot of hype around us. We just kind of put our heads down, toured really hard, wrote a bunch of records, and grinded it out to get to where we are. And I think that that might be a product of where we came from and just how this area operates.
So here we are on the Greiner farm. We started the band here on the property in 2003. And it doesn't look like where you would start a metal band. Obviously, you know, a metal band in Mannheim wasn't a very common thing, and no one really knew it was happening. But to have, you know, what used to be a chicken house as a practice space is a luxury, actually, because you have a lot of room and you have a free place to practice. Because we no longer utilize the chicken houses, because we stopped doing chickens, because we no longer have pigs and other livestock, the only thing we do on this farm is cash crops, we had a lot of empty space. So we kind of walked around the buildings, you know, would this be a good place? There's a lot of windows. Would this be a good place? It's wet, you know, it leaks. What about the egg room? When we first, found the egg room, there weren't any animals or any eggs to move. We had discontinued chickens back in 1998. We had broiler chickens. Before that, we had thousands of egg laying. Thus, we had what's called an egg room. And all an egg room is an insulated refrigerator. It was literally just an empty room that wasn't being used. And so it was perfect for us because we didn't need much space. At the time, we were running Thrill Seeker. And because we were starting to write our first full length, there's so much time dedicated to writing. And you couldn't really just section off a part of the day. I was doing landscaping. JB was working for the local grocery store in Anaheim. And so whenever we had free time, we'd come in here. So here you can see what we did to remedy the problem that we had with stuff falling from the ceiling. Put up sheets, we stapled them. And at the time, obviously, stuff wasn't sagging like this. It was pretty tight. And so you could see, you know, as you looked up, you're in the middle of, you know, playing a song. You look up and you see this little, you know, motion in the sheet. And obviously it was a mouse. And there were mice, plural. This was just the perfect space. I know it doesn't look like much, but the most important thing to us as a band was being together playing. And this room was integral, very, very, very important for us early on for a good 2 years. We moved out because of space, and that was probably in late 2005, 2006, I would say, mid, only to move about 50 feet that way. After we moved out of the egg room, we moved up here. We wrote Messengers, Constellations, Leveler, and I wrote Drums for Rescue and Restore up here. As you can see on the wall, there are at least 10 different set lists from early 2006 to 2012. There were some challenges. There were some challenges to practicing on the farm for me personally, which was if Dad was working, I felt awful being up here. Because here I am doing my thing and he's out there combining corn and needs help, you know, hauling wagons back. And so I'd be walking up here to practice. This happened so many times. And Dad's working and I think to myself, oh my gosh. Like, I feel so bad because I'm here, but I'm not helping. And so there would be a couple practices where I'd come out early, call up the guys. Guys, can we push practice back 2-3 hours? So then I'd work out there. Soon as I'm done, walk up here, pick up sticks, and get to playing. I remember the guys used to take their picks and throw them at the ceiling because they would stick. That's why you see all the markings. But we moved out when I bought a house. We were at Found in Faraway Places at my house in Lititz, which is about 10 minutes away. We moved off the Greiner farm. after being here for years and years and years. I think my dad was probably pretty happy. It's funny, actually, how many similarities there are between growing up on a farm and learning the skills of the trade and how that, you know, transcends into other arenas, even as crazy as it is, music. Something breaks, you have to figure out how to fix it. And if you're on a highway in Wyoming and there's nothing for 150 miles and you need to get to the show that night, just the willpower to say, well, this happened and we have to figure out how to get back on the road and get to the show.